Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Today, I'll talk to you about some of Guru Nanak Dev Ji's teachings and how we can apply them into our day-to-day lives. I'll answer the questions in order as they're asked. In the Sakhi Nako Hindu Na Musulman, Guru Nanak Dev Ji says that a true religious person must be devoted to God in both spirit as well as one's worldly actions. The basic teachings for Hindus and Muslims are similar, since both are created by the same God. One must always remember God, earn a living by honest labor, and share one's earnings with the poor and needy. Naam japo, kirt karo, vandke chako. The same is applicable to us Sikhs in today's world. Often, we go through emotions that make us seem to be Sikhs, such as wearing bhakta, coming to gurdwaras regularly, and staying till after langar. However, only few of us sit and listen to kirtan and katha. If we truly want to follow Guruji's message, we must all strive to listen, understand, and apply the teachings of Gurbani in our day-to-day lives so that we can become true Sikhs, inside and out. The message highlighted in the Sakhi, taking money to the next world, is of utmost importance, which is the story of a rich man Duni Chand, was not even content even with a big mansion and 7 flags on his rooftop. He could not even tell Guruji what else he would need to make him happy from within. He was baffled when Guruji gave him a needle and asked for it to be returned in the next world. This way, Guruji taught him that wealth he's collecting cannot go with him after he dies. However, he can use the wealth to perform good deeds and help those in need. This is simple, yet important lessons, and I'll apply this in my life by not running after the newest toy in the market or the biggest iPhone, etc. Instead, I'll focus on studying hard to gain knowledge, read Gurbani, and find ways to help those in need. In parts of the above discussed Sakhis, we learned that not only earning a living is important, but one must do so by honest and truthful means. This teaching is further emphasized in the story of Bhumia, who is a thief, whose life was transformed after he promised to abide by Guru Nanak Dev Ji's 3 lessons for him. Do not rob the poor, always speak the truth, do not deceive or steal from whose soul you have tasted. Once he started acting on those teachings, he was appointed a minister in the king's court due to his truthfulness. From Bhumia's example in these 3 lessons, I learned that, as a Sikh, I must always strive to lead an honest and truthful life, and that I should be loyal to those who have helped me in my journey. As a result, my mind will always be at peace, and I'll eventually attain true success, as I will become a Gurmukh. As a Gurmukh, one must realize the power of truth, and even more important, truthful living. Sache ore sabko upar sach achar. In the story of Sajjan Thug, Guruji emphasized that truthful and virtuous earning is better than earning by killing and robbing. In the Sakhi Getting Rid of Ego with Truth, Guru Nanak Dev Ji taught the yogis that the way to get rid of oneself of these vices was to gain knowledge of the truth, which is attained by singing praises of God. To do this, it is not necessary to leave one's home to meditate in the mountains. I can apply the lessons learned from both these Sakhis by not taking long exams to get good grades or lying about my homework assignments. If I do my path regularly and attend Gurdwara, I can learn to control my anger, ego, greed, and fear. Before I end, I'd like to share part of one of Guru Nanak Dev Ji's hymns that is dear to my heart and attempt to explain its meaning. Then I help Bhakti, which has a gist of Shabbat listed on Sorat Mella Pella on Ang 595 in Guru Granth Sahib Ji as it follows. Baba Maya Satna Hoy, In Maya Jag Moya Verle Buje Koi Rahao. The Rahao or Short Sabri indicates that Maya, or wealth, does not go with anyone, just as we saw in the above discussion about Duni Chand. Guruji says that Maya, or wealth, or materialistic charms have bewitched everyone, but only few understand this truth. In the rest of the Shabbat, Guruji emphasizes the importance of being modest, humble, and content, as well as the importance of Namsimran and and proclamation of God. We should all take these messages and try to apply them into our day-to-day lives. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.